Talofa Lava and hello. We're back from our October recess here in Parliament, and it's been a great recess in terms of being back in the electorate. While I was in the electorate, I had 2 days out at Whenuapai Airport at the Air Force base for the Air Force. Part of my placement was to experience and look at how our Air Force operate within the Defence Forces of New Zealand. Spent a lot of time with the servicemen and women of the Air Force, looking into their operations. And I went out on a P3 Orion to look at how they conduct surveillance and their operations around illegal fishing of our coastal waters and our New Zealand's economic zone. While at the Air Force, I also had the privilege of seeing the various units and how the Air Force play a really integral role within the Defence Forces, particularly around search and rescue missions up into the islands, and also airlifting of cargo and people both from and to New Zealand. This past week we've also had the council elections, and I commend all those that put their hand up to be elected into council. Many obviously succeeded, but a whole lot many failed, and you know, it's a commendable thing to run for public office. For those that succeeded, I wish you well in the duties and responsibilities that you have going forward, not just in Auckland and Maungakiekie, but across the country. And for those that didn't, commiserations. In my local area, Denise Crum succeeded in toppling the long-term councillor Richard Northey. And I congratulate Denise. She ran an outstanding campaign. She's a quite a popular local figure, being the chair of one of the local primary schools and doing a lot of charity work in the Maungakiekie area. I certainly look forward to working with Denise as well as the local board on issues that matter to people that live in the Maungakiekie and Tamaki areas. Another local issue that I dealt with over the break was around the smart approaches, flight paths to Auckland Airport. There are some trials that are being conducted at the moment around smart approaches, which means that the aircraft save on fuel efficiency by taking shorter routes to Auckland Airport. However, it does mean that some of the aircraft fly at lower altitudes than is normal, and there's been a little bit of discomfort locally from local people who have really feel like that the noise has resulted in lower quality of life, but also the consultation around the smart approaches trials. And I'm dealing with the Auckland Airports and Airways Corporation, as well as local constituents, to work through those issues as we go forward. The trial will end on the 31st of October this month. Looking forward, I've got the Minister of Education, the Honourable Heke Parata, coming to the electorate this Friday. I'm looking forward to hosting her. We're visiting a couple of local schools, Royal Oak Primary School, as well as Bailey Road School in Mount Wellington. We'll also be meeting with local teachers and local educational groups. So I'm really looking forward to that visit on Friday during the day. For now, I wish you all well. And it is New UN Language Week this week. So I say whakalofa lai atu and whakau e lahi, and wish you well during this important week for New UNs in New Zealand.